City Live, a platform to sharing your thoughts. City Live, a platform to sharing your thoughts.
Hello and namaste everybody. Myself, Nisha Jaluri, welcoming you all to yet another exciting, exotic and yummy session. Exotic and yummy, because in this session today, we are going to celebrate the festival of flavors with the monsoon season. Kehte hain, happiness is enjoying the rain with good food. बारिश की रिमझिम रिमझिम फुहारे हो और गर्म चाय की प्याली के साथ गर्मा गर्म पकौड़े मिल जाए तो बस फिर कहना ही क्या, बात करते करते ही बरबस मुंह में पानी आ गया. When we go totally weary of the scorching, biting summery heat, comes the monsoon season and brings with it the season of corn. So this month, we at Nisha Jaluri Events decided to celebrate the corn carnival with the rainy season. Nothing brings people together than good food. Joining me on this session today are two foodies. We got together for good food. So here are my two co-hosts, Nishat Seth and Ruksana Banu from Bangalore.
Hi.
Hi. Now, Nishat is a foodie, a passionate cook. She also has an Instagram page wherein she keeps everybody engaged through her yummy-licious dishes and organizing many lip-smacking activities. So, hi, Nishat. A warm welcome to you.
Thank you, Nisha ji.
Thank you for being a part of the Corn Carnival and joining me on this session. Now, Nisha, please tell us as to what this Corn Carnival was all about.
I'll tell you all. But first thing, I would thank you, Nisha ji, Nisha Jaluri Events, for accepting this Corn Carnival and hosting it so wonderfully. Okay, now going on the Corn Carnival. Actually, we are running this contest and we want all the participants to make a dish, a new unique dish with this corn, with a new innovation and presentation. So then we had told the participants to send their dishes on WhatsApp.
Okay. So
the main thing was that we told them to send a pic of the dish and their pic with the dish to on a given WhatsApp number.
Okay. Why their pic with the dish?
Okay, good question. Actually, because now everything is on the internet and you see anyone can do any kind of copy or something. So if the dish is made with their own hands and their pic is there with the dish, then it's a genuine entry. That's why.
Okay. So you were just trying to avoid, you know, copying from the internet. Great.
Yeah, because we can't taste it. That's why.
I know. So you didn't want that the participants copy the dish from the internet, you know.
And exactly.
So that's a really nice thought, yeah. So, and we have on the floor yet another co-host, Ruksana Banu.
Hello, Nisha ji.
Hi, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Absolutely fine. Now, Ruksana is a blogger, YouTuber and a digital marketing strategist. She has done store operating procedure audits for many premium brands like Louis Vuitton, Burberry, Montblanc and many more. She's the co-founder of Haya Events, founder of Velvets and Pearls, a certified chocolatier, a professional trousseau packing and gift wrapping expert. She also has a YouTube channel wherein she has more than 15,000 subscribers. Oh my God. A warm welcome to you, Ruksana.
That's so kind of you. Thank you so much, Nisha ji.
Thanks for being a part of the Corn Carnival and joining me on this session. Now, Ruksana, if you could tell everybody as to what was the criteria for judgment on this session.
The criteria for the judgment was unique and creative recipe.
Okay. So you didn't add the taste part to it.
No, I wish we got to taste all these yummy recipes. I was drooling, looking at the pictures. But this was a virtual contest. And maybe after this pandemic ends, we would like to, go on a contest where we can taste these food. Seriously? I hope we can collaborate once again, you, me, and Nishat, for the upcoming contest.
Oh, yes, Rikshana, that would be a pleasure, actually. Yeah. I would just love to collaborate with you with the kind of credentials that you have. You know, it would be a real pleasure. So, thank you.
It is so kind of you and Nishat, to collaborate with you and Nishat. Last time we had Mango Fest and we got amazing... we got amazing response for that. And so that is why we thought of doing this Corn Carnival. So maybe next time we come up with a unique contest.
Definitely, we surely will. And I will agree with you that we really missed on the taste part as one of the judgment criteria. Otherwise, we would get to savor the yummy dishes all by ourselves, you know.
Yeah.
So before going forward, a special word of special thanks to Mrs. Shilpa Garg from Daz Foods Ajmer to be a sponsor on this event. Thank you so much, Nishat, and thank you so much, Rukhsana, for joining me in this session. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Nishat.
Bye. Food is maybe the only universal thing that has the power to bring everyone together. Moving forth now, we have on board our esteemed judge, Chef Nishant Chaubey, and the first, second, and the third prize winners of the Corn Carnival contest. It's gonna take more than a clever cook to get a dish right. It's gonna take a magician. And today we are privileged and honored to have amidst us our esteemed judge, Chef Nishant Chaubey. It's gonna take me many sessions to list all his achievements. But briefing them up, I'd like to tell all of you that Chef Nishant Chaubey was selected for Southern US Foods Program training. He won Iron Chef Challenge in Bangkok. He represented India at Michigan, Indianapolis Universities, Dusit Nairobi, Montenegro, World Gourmet Summit, Singapore, Madrid Fusion 2015, Indus Bangkok, and created successful cook-off at the vineyards of Argentina, South Africa, Japan, and Canada. He has been adorned with first prize at the Bocuse d'Or competition, gold medal at AHA 2013, Chef of the Year 2015, and Grand Avant Chef Award. He's also part of TV shows with Tata Sky and Zee Business. Presently, he's corporate chef to Senan Tokyo and consulting chef to Michelin-plated Indus Bangkok. Oh my God, totally speechless. I just bow down to all your achievements, all your accomplishments, Nishant. So now that the winners are here and the viewers would also like to know about you, your journey, please tell us, were you inclined to or did you have a passion for cooking right from your childhood?
I think yes. I think at the age of 14 only I prepared my first dish. So, and then I think I was really interested to start off, but never thought that I'll become chef. It just happened. It's a career that I did never choose, but it all happened and I'm quite satisfied at this moment of life when I'm getting some bit of remark and some bit of recognition, I would say. I'm quite happy, and still I feel that I'm still the same person when I started, and I have still lot to learn, lot to showcase and to show the world that, you know, how much Indian cuisine is used to be so good, and now since we are losing out, we should give it give due credit to our food and make it really, really global. Let people get interested. Let people honor our food. And the kind of processes which goes in making Indian food is far, far more than, you know, if you make any European or any continental dishes. It's far more complicated. It's far more tastier. It takes a lot of time. So there are so much of character to our food, and we must acclaim that with your honesty, hard work, passion, commitment, and overall, I think positive attitude is the key. If you lose someday, it doesn't mean that you can't win the next day. So yes, you need to be sure, you need to have that kind of positivity. That's the key to win the race. Whoever has won today, my heartiest congratulations. They have done very, very well. But whoever has participated, I would say that it is not that tomorrow they can't make history. So let's all keep participating, keep learning, and keep sharing it with all of us that we actually meet. So I think this is the mantra that I always live, and I'm quite happy in sharing it with people. As much as I know, I definitely like to share so that I grow with my people, with my team, and then finally, at the end of the day, you cannot achieve success alone. You need to have team to make it happen. I think this is what I would like to say.
So nice to hear from you, Nishant. So can I say ki an accidental chef?
Yes.
Is that happened? Yes. Okay,
sure.
Okay.
No. Yes, I think you are quite right in saying that. But after I went to my college, I never looked back. You know, I thought that, oh, this is the career which will either make me or break me. So I never thought of any option side by side to create. And I always have this mind that, you know, that one day I'll definitely become something. That's for sure. So I had this kind of thought process. So still I'm quite happy. Yeah.
So what was your inspiration behind pursuing, being a chef? So what was your inspiration?
So frankly speaking, I used to watch Sanjeev Kapoor on TV very, very often.
Okay.
So I always thought that such life, you know, I mean, the kind of food that he used to eat at that time. I said, you know, if I become chef, I would definitely, even if I don't cook, I'll be able to eat so much, you know. That kind of variety. So to be very, very candid, this was the inspiration to start off. And I think more, I mean, a lot of people who actually wanted to become chef, they will have a reason like this only. That, you know, you come on TV and then you'll get variety to taste, you get to meet all the celebrities of this world. And I think this looks very lucrative to start off. But I never thought that so much of hard work that has to be put in to make this happen. So hats off to all the chefs, actually. I mean, it looks very easy, but believe me, there's so much of hard work which has gone into. So my salam to everyone, actually. Yeah.
Okay, so mainly Sanjeev Kapoor. No, that's what you mentioned right now, actually.
Yes. That was the inspiration for sure, yes.
Okay, so hard work really pays. So now that you are, yes, a celebrity and internationally acclaimed chef, Nishant, please tell us as to what transformation has come about in your life after gaining all the name, fame, you know. So please, I'm sure everybody would be very keen on knowing this.
So when I was in the college, I always thought that I think I should learn as much as possible. And I always wanted to find niche. I never wanted to go in the race of people. You know, I thought that I'll make my own kind of identity. And that's what my target was. That, you know, if there's a queue, I would not like to be there. If there's something that I can do where, you know, I can make my value, I can show my value. So I think I was into that. And luckily, I used to see, I think in everyone's life, you always get opportunity. The only thing is that you need to say yes. So
your network's gone, looks like. Satyajit ji, kya ho gaya?
It is not happening, but so going and again saying it's very, very easy. But no, I mean, you go to Argentina and you land up and then you have cook-off happening tomorrow. So you need to be mentally and physically both prepared in the same time. So, but again, I never thought about that, you know, I mean, I will land and I'll do this and I'll do that. How would it be possible, whether I'll get hing or not to cook dal, whether I'll get rice flour or not. I never thought about it. But eventually what happened is that when I started exploring international work, I thought that, you know, why don't I look at the produce, what is happening there, and then make my menu accordingly. So I think that's very, very important for us, that you look at corn and then make your dish. You know, don't prepare, you don't think that I'm going to do this and then that's what I mean, these are the things that I require. You should always look at what is available and then make your food. I think that was one of the things that made me confident. But I would definitely like to pinpoint, in Bangkok, one of the projects that I did with Dr. Pushpesh Pant, and we never thought that we will be able to recreate Harappa or Indus Valley civilization, which is almost 7,000 years ago. I mean, that civilization that we can recreate in Bangkok and show them the Indian history is so civilized and Indian history is so nice and it's so articulate and so much of food angle to that. So that's exactly what I mean, that place started giving me a lot of identity, and people started looking at Silk Route, Spice Route of the world, Indus Valley civilization, all these things which came very handy, and people started understanding that how, you know, Leh Ladakh till Pakistan, I'm talking about that, what was the food and how camel used to be there and how you people used to drink, how people used to eat on terracotta or probably leaves and brass plates and copper plates. So this is a great research that I did in my life, and because of that I'm getting continuous connects. Once you prove yourself internationally, you get a lot of connect in your life. The only thing, you have to be ready for it. You have to always say yes. If you say no, I can't do it, I will think about it, then somebody else will take the opportunity. So you need to be prepared mentally and physically both in order to get that due recognition, which I somehow, a little bit of that I have got. I'm still long way to go.
Okay. So nice to know this. So any tip that you'd like to give to the younger generation of today who want to pursue their career as chefs?
My tip would be that, you know, keep yourself positive. As I said before, I mean, never bog down to any situation. Just be prepared that you will get into that situation, and just think that how you will find positivity in that. This is the time when we get so. I mean, this is the time when we have so much in hand that we can research, we can look back, we can understand old school technology. We can understand that how you can prepare a lot of things using very, you know, using control situation when you have only a few equipments to work with. So I think always keep yourself positive, always keep yourself cheerful, because food is something that will never go off. It's just a little bit of, you know, a time gap in our life, and we should use it judiciously and make the best use of it. Don't waste it. Think that you are in a kitchen and then visualize in that way only. Plan yourself, be disciplined. Of course, eat healthy, nutritious food, because jo fit hai, wahi hit hai. That's very, very important. Look at your fitness for sure. And those are the keys. I mean, that's what. And keep yourself positive. Attitude should be always positive.
Okay, so positive is the key according to Chef Nishant. So thanks for being an important part of the Corn Carnival. We are truly honored and privileged to have you as our esteemed judge. And so let us know as to how you felt being associated with the Corn Carnival.
No, I find it really nice, because it's not that I'm telling you nice, but you know, you have picked up something which is very seasonal. And this is the mantra right now. We need to be dependent, I would say, on our seasonal crop. So you found corn, which is an amazing ingredient for vegetarian, and not only for vegetarian. In fact, for meat eaters also, it's quite nice because it has amazing texture. You can boil it, you can puree it, you can steam it, you can roast it. you know, there are several ways which corn can be used. And also I like Nisha one thing that, you know, it's a crop which is very well respected outside India. I mean, I was talking about, as you mentioned about my US Louisiana trip, I saw some bit of lovely sweet corns, you know, and then that was a staple vegetable in their diet. And that was fabulous. So if any recipe I like here and I can put it up in my internet, I'm sure the entire world will understand about that recipe. So I think that's what I like the best, that you picked up a seasonal crop. Why don't you just keep continuing it and keep giving people, these seasonal crops, which are very, very, very beneficial in terms of our health. And of course, a lot can be done about it. So my heartiest congratulations.
Thank you so much, Nishant. And we'll definitely try and keep it up in the future also and follow it and take sure. it up again.
Please, you know? Please. Yeah.
A recipe has no soul, but you as the cook bring soul to the recipe. Moving forward to those who have brought souls to their recipes. Ji haan, hamare prize winners. So beginning with our third prize winner, Lubna Rashid from Bangalore.
Hi, hope all of you are doing well.
Yes, absolutely.
Lovely speaking to you, Nisha. And also, Chef, thank you so much for that insight. It was amazing to hear all those.
So, hearty congratulations to you, Lubna. Lubna, please tell us as to how you felt being a part of the corn carnival and also about your dish, corn boba.
So, I'll first start off with my dish. I had something else planned in mind. I wanted to do a dessert, more of a baked dessert, but that didn't work out. And I'm a big fan of boba. I'm a big fan of water chestnuts or boba, and I like experimenting with those foods. I generally don't go into the kitchen. I go once in a while to bake something and I'm out. But I love corn. I absolutely love corn. You'll always find me eating popcorn. So my mom's like, listen, I found something. This is perfect for you. Just try it. I'm a little reluctant person. Then I was like, you know what? Okay, fine. Let's try it. Usme kya jata hai? Anyways, don't have much to do. Have enough time. So I took it up and I was thinking, okay, what do we do? So there was this thing that I used to make with water chestnut. It was originally with water chestnut. It was like a smoothie that my sister and I used to make. It was inspired by Thailand. And I thought maybe perhaps, just by chance, we could incorporate this in some other way. And ultimately, I found a blogger who was talking about how you could use boba and corn together. And I said, okay, I'm going to try this. This looks amazing. And I made two batches. The first two batches were bad. And the third batch, I'm like, no, I know I have to get it right. And ultimately, I just, you know, started styling it properly, started putting it all together, and it turned out pretty amazing. And so the entire journey for me was a challenge because I honestly didn't expect it to turn out the way it did. I had no expectations at all. And like I said, I'm not very good at in the kitchen. So I was a little hesitant. I was like, am I messing it up? Am I doing this right? Until it didn't come together, I was very cynical about the whole thing. But it was a fun learning. It was really a lot of fun.
Okay. So this mess turned out really, you know, good. A prize winner, in fact, for you. So, and I'm sure now you will go to the kitchen more often.
Maybe.
Look, okay, Chef, I have only one suggestion.
Yes.
Yeah. So I loved your presentation. I think I was quite kind of really liked them, that you put them in the glass and you have some green and then you like the color contrast. Only thing that I would advise you here, if you don't mind, that if you actually try to use natural colors, you have used red color, right?
Yes.
So if you can avoid one. And if you can add a little bit of berry or red fruit, anything right. which because you wanted some kind of contrast, I believe, right? In
yes.
the glass.
Yes.
So if you can use some red currant or some red cherry, something like that. So I think that will be nice. Because we all want the food to be very natural. We don't want the food to have artificial color. So that's the only suggestion I have.
Thank you so much.
In fact, In fact, I can just give you a few options if you want. You can use blue tea or you can use hibiscus. Okay. I think if you can incorporate blue tea, it will make it, it will give you a little bit of blue color, natural blue color. And hibiscus is, of course, red color. So you can use that.
How would you incorporate
hibiscus? That was the next step. Sorry?
How would you incorporate hibiscus?
So hibiscus, what you have to do is just, you get dehydrated hibiscus.
Okay.
I will message, if you want, I will message the number to Nisha and she can share with you.
Yes,
and
absolutely.
You can just, you find those dehydrated hibiscus.
Okay.
Or rosella, is also, you know, the same family.
Right, yes,
so you just put it in water and then, you use that water, basically. The water will become nice and red.
Oh,
so if
okay.
you are making dim sum, if you are making fried rice, if you are making a dessert like a cheesecake, you can use these natural colors and make it very colorful. In the same time, healthy as well. You know, tea is very healthy.
That's an excellent tip. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. And congratulations. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
I'm sure, Lubna, next time you're definitely going to keep in mind not to use artificial colors.
Definitely. This has been a learning. And I'm going to try the hibiscus thing. I'm very curious to see how that works.
Please do
out.
That. Please do that. Please do that. It works really well.
Thank you so much.
Okay. Now the second prize winner, Rashi Agarwal from Ajmer. Hi, Rashi.
Hello, ma'am.
Hi.
How are you? How are you, sir?
How are you?
Very well. Very well.
Thank you.
Hearty congratulations to you, Rashi. Rashi, please tell us as to how you felt being associated with the corn carnival and also about your dish, Trinity Corn Ravioli Galette.
Ma'am, I felt very delighted but yet very nervous because it's totally opposite for my career as I'm a CA.
Oh.
So, but love for cooking was always there in me from childhood, I guess. And when I saw your mango face, I was very much desperately waiting for the upcoming contest. And when I saw the Khan Carnival, I was like, I'm going to take part this time for sure. But I was damn confused about the recipe, what to cook or what not. So finally, I decided to mix two recipes, which I normally do at my home too. I mingle up the recipe of ravioli and galette together. And for the confidence, which I was not getting, I let my family to taste it first. So I can get that confidence build up in me that it, is it working really together good or not. And when they confirm that it's really yum, I got that confidence. And it was my first cooking competition. So I was very honored when I received your call. I felt very happy that participating it for first time, I got rewarded for my presentation and for my recipe. And thank you so much, sir, for liking my crazy idea of mixing two recipes together. I really felt very honored.
So Nishant, what was so special about this dish, you know?
I think she already mentioned that these are the two things that she made.
Yes.
In a time, she also made ravioli, she stuffed it and then she baked it. So it was quite nice. Again, I'll have one advice for you as well.
Sure,
sir. You have also used a little bit of green color. So if you can look at spinach, pak choy, these kind of options, next time you can take the next level probably. So
for sure, sir. I'm going to take it.
If you can just look at that. Otherwise, your recipe is quite nice. The way you done it, the way you made the dough and then you filled it up and then you made it like a shape and then you baked it. Quite nice. Very, very interesting. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
You have anything to ask, you can always ask.
Yeah, sure. I'll do it. Any more suggestions if you want to add?
No, I think apart from color, your shapes are quite nice. I mean, this is a virtual thing, but I liked it. Overall, it's very, very satisfying that you took inspiration from ravioli and galette both, the French and Italian way of doing. So it's nice. It's like, if I look at my Indian cuisine, if I look at dhokli, the dal dhokli thing, okay. So I can improvise that in the similar fashion. because you wanted that soft texture to become crispy, and that's why you baked it. So there's a valid reason of why you did it. This is not fusion. This is progression. So I think I'm quite happy seeing this.
Thank you so much. I feel so honored, sir. Thank you so much, ma'am, for this opportunity.
Most welcome.
So Rashi, your idea of merging the two, you know, cuisines, you know, blending them two together, you know, really clicked. So a big round of applause to you.
Thank you so much.
Moving on now to the winner of the Corn Carnival, Achal Mittal from Hyderabad.
Hi, Nisha. Hello, sir. How are you?
Hello. Hi. Very well. Thank you.
Oh my God, Achal, when we had contestants participating from all across the globe and you emerging as the winner. So how is the feeling? Please let us know.
It's amazing, Nisha. I mean, it was actually a very unexpected call that day. I didn't even check my Insta and I received the call from you. So it was actually indeed very surprising and amazing. So it was great. I mean, it all started with, because never imagined actually sweet corn using in a form of a dessert. So it was something totally, this platform actually helped me think that way, that sweet corn can also be used in the form of a dessert.
Yes.
Yeah, so I have two kids. So actually when I started experimenting with this recipe, they were like, Mom, how can you use sweet corn in an ice cream? We can never taste that ice cream. So it started with that. And then I said, okay, let's try and let's see how it forms. So finally, the inspiration was actually from cassata and Shahi Tukda. So the traditional two things, and I mean, those two are my favorite desserts actually. So it started from there. So the creamy corn was the rubbery, not very thick rubbery, and the cake was actually the, you know, the Shahi Tukda part, the healthier version of that. So non-fried and using applesauce to make that very less sweetened bread. So so the ultimate aim was to get a dessert which tastes good, and finally topped it up with nuts and blueberry syrup. So so that was the whole idea behind that.
Oh, very good. So and how was your experience, you know, about the Corn Carnival?
It was great. It was amazing. In fact, I'll be looking forward to more such things. So cooking, actually, I enjoy cooking, especially, you know, trying and modifying the recipes to include the healthy touch in that. So I keep doing that usually. And that's how, I mean, when I got to know about this, I was like, okay, just let me give it a try and see what happens. So it was indeed a very great experience overall. So thanks a lot for that.
Okay, welcome anytime. And Nishant, please tell us as to what made this recipe stand out, you know, of all the recipes that we've received.
Frankly speaking, this is very unusual. As she said that, you know, converting it to a dessert is itself, and making dessert is not easy out of corn. So first and foremost, that was one thing. And then the kind of presentation that she did is absolutely great. And she actually made three things. You know, she the hard work showed, you know, she had made a bread, she had made an ice cream, and she also used chia seeds. She made a rubbery kind of texture. So I think she combined everything very, very well. So had I been there, I would have definitely tasted and given my, opinion about how it tastes. But I'm sure the kids would have said, Mom, thumbs up. They have given thumbs up to their mom. So I think I like overall this work very, very well to me. I mean, I'm very, very inspired to see this recipe of Cornado that she has done. So I think I'm quite happy. If she can, only thing is if she can again move away from syrup and then try to use natural things, I would be, I'm sure you as well, because she's also talking about health, which is great. If she can omit and she can do some bit of regular fruit reduction basically, or little bit of fermented fruit reduction, if you can incorporate little bit of kombucha or fermented any product in that way, because fermented food is very good for our gut system. So then it will go into the next level, because that will also give a little bit of sourness. I think any sweet dish, if it has a little bit of sourness, it works more Okay, so if you look at cheesecake, they put lime in that because again, if you put lime or orange, you know, these kind of citrus fruit, it evolves. So grapefruit ho gaya, or if we have very nice star fruit, you can always incorporate some bit of star fruit in that, which is locally found and is very much into the season now. So you can use this citrus fruit to make it more colorful. You can also use some bit of, you can use the grapefruit segments. If you can put some bit of grapefruit segments on top of your dessert, again, the presentation will evolve because those will be nice and red and citrus and juicy. So I think this is a little bit of suggestion from my side, but overall it was quite nice. Thank you. Congratulations. If you have anything to ask, please do let me know.
Yeah, sure. So actually the citrus thing is really a good suggestion. I'll definitely try that next time.
Yeah.
For sure.
Please do
but
that.
Coming to the blueberries, actually that was a homemade syrup. So I used the dried blueberries.
Okay.
And it created a syrup using that. So
that's fine. That's nice. That's quite nice. So you made something like a compote, right? Like a compote.
Yeah, compote. Right. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Fair enough.
I'm sure all the winners have benefited a lot from the tips given by our chef. So hearty congratulations once again, and a big thanks to all of you, especially Chef Nishant Chaubey for sparing his valuable time to join us on this session. And now, good food ends with good talk. So live, love, cook and eat. Stay safe and be happy. Thank you.
City Live, a platform to sharing your thoughts.